and they were approached by four undercover officers around 10:30 p.m. and later told by a superior officer that there was a memo to clean you guys up. Woodward spent 24 hours in central booking, and both men's loitering charges were dismissed after a single court appearance. So basically fucking with people to fuck with people.
Man.
Well, $54,000 later.
They should have got more than
that. Exactly.
I mean, yo, we could all, like, all the people in here probably have some sort of...
One story at least.
Yeah.
About some harassment.
Harassment and performing. Yo, it doesn't... You can do that. It's not illegal. You don't have... You can't have a speaker.
You're not here peddling nothing.
You know? You're not selling anything most times. Yeah, and I watch this stuff all the time. People always have a... cops always have a reason.
Of course.
In New York City. So, you know what, I just feel like for musicians and for people that we know in the room, that's a win. That's a win. It's not like it's showtime. And even if it's showtime, okay, no, you get them showtime niggas. Like, I'm sorry, forget it.
Because
they come this close to kicking my face
it's
every
a lot
time.
Of showtime dudes is just straight whack, though.
Yeah.
Like, you can't even really dance, bro.
Clean up the
like,
whack showtime dudes.
What are you doing?
Yo, shout out to everybody in the chat room, yo. Yeah, so, that's it. Yeah. Are you busking anytime soon? Are you over that? Are you
mad?
Beyond that?
It's been a minute.
Have you though?
I have, like, there was a couple times I was pretty hard up, like.
Yeah.
I was like, let me just play a little. Yo. Bit. You know, like, I definitely had twice.
Yeah.
But that was it.
Is it scary?
I was scared.
Yeah.
I think
I wasn't scared of a thing other than myself.
Yeah, like.
So it's like, what if this is whack?
Right.
You know, like, I don't want to be that person.
What subway station did you go to, or a train?
Oh, where you?
Somewhere, I was off, like, 14th.
Yeah, that's a good spot. 14th.
Yeah.
Union Square, exactly.
Yeah,
right up in that.
But
okay.
I feel like the other people are looking at you like, yo. And I'm like, whose territory is this? I don't
right.
know the rules. I don't know the mapping.
I don't want to get cut.
Yo, don't go where the Q train is, because somebody's always there. The dude with the lights that does the breakdancing and he put the lights in his mouth. Like, don't go there because that dude got it on lock. And then there's always a beatboxing dude there. Yeah.
It's been so long. I can't wait to go look at them all.
Yo, you know what? Let's get into some music. I think I have some. Do we have some in the... I have some Sarah White in our playlist. And you'll tell us more about things.
Yeah, I brought you one too.
Yeah, and she brought... See, I'm claiming that too.
I pulled two songs. Don't play August 2nd, play the other one.
Okay. Huesos?
Huesos.
Yes.
Huesos.
Huesos.
What does that mean?
Bones.
Ooh.
And that has a double meaning. There's a not dirty meaning and there's a general meaning.
You know what? Let's play. Cause deep in here, he knows Spanish. Mm-hmm. You know
what? That means.
Sarah's gonna tell us about huesos later. You're listening to TK and the AM on Bonfire Radio.
TK in the AM, Huesos.
Yes.
By Sarah White. We're just going to let this Huesos. Flip over a little bit while she talks
like
about
that.
The song.
I like that. Can you repeat what you just said?
That last line,
What was
though?
The last line?
The last line is, throw me a bone, let me bend over it.
Oh, girl.
And I mean, it's
yeah.
It goes two ways. Like this
that goes a lot of ways.
It goes. So it's about kind of like letting shit die. Something
yes.
that's not feeding you anymore.
Yes.
And you think about bones as like, bones stick around long after the flesh. Long
yeah.
yeah.
After the spirit leaves the body. And yeah, I just came out of an
yeah.
11-year relationship.
Oh, so yeah.
I had to start
ghosts.
Over.
Mad
I had
ghosts.
To like really go into the parts of myself that had, you know, grown and changed and shifted.
Yeah.
As I was in this part of my life.
Yeah.
And I decided instead of trying to like mask it, just to go in.
Ooh.
You know, just go into all of it. And then also just find myself as a woman, as a creative, as a sexual being.
Yeah.
And just be really expressive about it, unapologetic.
How does that
That's dope.
For you, besides music, how does that manifest for you? Like going in, leaning into the feeling, leaning into the letting go of the ghost. How does that, outside of
yeah.
the music, how does that
it's
manifest
kind of like
for
a
you?
Full-time job.
Yeah.
You know, I teach yoga to women of color in the north side of Minneapolis. I live pretty holistically. I practice a lot of different physical practices to kind of go into myself.
Mm.
I do a lot of work in the community with social justice. And in general, like, I'll go out and dance until 6 a.m. if I need to. Like, I'm just trying to, like, find my parameters and figure out what
yeah.
I need.
Yeah.
And not apologize about it.
Yeah, and there's no way to do that myself. Without doing it.
Exactly. You just got to do it.
Yo, the
it's not pretty. I'll
the not apologizing yeah. thing, that's everything.
And I keep saying sorry. And I'm like, no, I'm not sorry.
Yeah.
You know, sorry, not sorry. I'm just who I am.
I'm just who I am. Chalet Lady said, I love the song, but hearing you speak over it means even more.
Yeah.
Oh,
wow. Speak on it. It means even more.
Yeah,
you know?
It's funny because I write in kind of like parallels.
Yeah.
So it's like people are like, oh, that's sweet. I'm like, no, I'm doing shit.
You're going in.
You know, but I know how to do it in a really like poetical way that's accessible. You can just sit and bob around and listen to it. But if you really listen to the lyrics, you understand that like it's pretty epic.
There's listening. Then there's listening.
Yeah.
And I think there's like that layer that people tap into after they've experience what you're experiencing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So like, yeah, like I'm listening to it. Boop. But I also didn't get out of a 10-year relationship.
Yeah.
Right? Like, shout out to Koopy in the chat room. She said, I feel you. I just got out of a 10-year relationship. Shit is sad face.
It's so real.
Yeah.
It's like, and I'm pretty like strong, powerful woman. Like I can handle whatever. And I found myself just feeling like my face was flat on the cement some days. Just like, dang, what is my life right now?
But yeah.
On the other end, I feel powerful.
Yeah.
I don't feel like anything can stop me.
Shit is powerful, yo.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for sharing that, yo.
You're welcome.
Kylie NYC 2PR, she said, funny when messages are on time. Love the song and the message.
Thank you, boo.
Folks are into it, yo. Let's jump back into a little bit more news you could use because there's some stuff happening, and I just thought it was important. Our friends in San Francisco, they're going through some stuff right now.
Oh, boy.
Well, I don't want to say oh boy yet, but yes, okay. Oh boy. As the headline pops up on my screen, activists protest SFPD shootings with Mission District hunger strike. So there's a one of our creative friends in San Francisco. He is calling for the, the stepping down of either the mayor or the police chief in San Francisco in Mission District by staging a hunger strike. He has been on hunger strike since... This story came out on the 21st, so since before April 21st, it's the 29th right now. His name is, he's a local rapper and activist called Ilyich Egipto. I'm sorry, I'm not saying it right. Am I saying it right? Come here, Spanish dude.
Come here, Spanish dude.
Right here.
Read this for me.
What's his name?
Ilyich Egipto.
Oh, there he is. It's a play on word because he's a rapper. Okay, well, we tried. But we're going to, you know what we're going to do? We're going to tweet it, and then we're going to put it in the chat room so y'all could Google
what
it.
What your name is, bro.
And then we could support him. But he's leading a small group of activists on a hunger strike outside of the police station in San Francisco. They're calling themselves the Black and Brown Social Club.
Ooh.
They plan to stay in front of the station consuming nothing but liquids until Police Chief Greg Suher is fired or resigns. Well, but not in the police station. I doubt it. I doubt they're going to let him in.
I'm not suggesting they piss on the police station.
Yeah. Ooh, no. See, oh,
I'm not
right.
saying that. I didn't because say that
because they'll try
at all.
To lock him up. For.
I totally didn't say that.
You get locked up for 7 days.
Right. You get locked up for less.
Yeah.
So, you know, but now that the media is involved, they're not going to lock anybody up in front.
They can make sun tea and just leave the bottles.
Just leave bottles. Sun tea. Ike Pinkson, he's a hunger strike participant and member of the social club. He said, this is just a really deep issue and it shows no signs of letting up and we need to do something radical. I'll stay out here for forever, however long it takes, 1 week, 2 weeks, 2 months. And they are also like, there have been mad shootings in San Francisco of Black and Brown people. I mean, like everywhere, but this is like something that, here we go.
Yeah.
I had to tell you.
Oh, no, that's not the one.
Not
there
on.
You go. Yeah, you're listening, Mo, but your mic is on. Deep is in the building.
Yeah,
this is a different kind of radical activism.
Yeah.
Like, usually, you know, we march and we do things and we self-care, but this is like, if you don't eat at some point, you might.
Well, last year, the kids at the college.
Right.
Yeah.
What did they do? They just sat.
They did a hunger strike.
Yeah, at the college. Will a school? Not a school. Will these people let these people starve to death? Do you think? Or will somebody really step down? Like, will a mayor?
San Francisco always has this like progressive air about it. And I mean, I've been to San Francisco times, and I've been to the Mission District. It is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's the thing about America, because they say that the more liberal-looking a place is, low-key, it's not.
Yeah.
And San Francisco looks looks okay. Super. Yeah, yeah. Right. It,
you know what?
It looks sexy.
I don't think the actual hunger strike is what makes things change. I think it just brings attention and other people start doing other things and mobilize. Because they don't fucking care if you starve.
Right.
They're killing you, so they don't care about that.
Like,
I always thought about that.
Like, they care.
But it's the other people unified and doing other things and starting to think and starting to speak and causing problems for them mm-hmm. that makes the hunger strike make sense. Yeah. It's not even about them not eating.
It breaks the illusion.
Yeah, they don't care if you die. So, like, you not eating doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They said, we've exhausted every option to seek justice for black and brown community here in San Francisco, especially when San Francisco is pushing people further and further, further and further out. And then there's the Google buses that bus people in and out of Silicon Valley. And also, because of the Google buses, not to say because of them, but because of where they stop, the rents are going up because people want to live where the Google bus stop is so they could go to work, right? Right, right. So, and then they're shooting homeless. So this is really the most recent shooting was a homeless man that was wielding a small knife, and they shot him to death. 28-year-old Alex Nieto was killed by police 2 years ago. He was armed with a taser that police thought was a pistol. 26-year-old Mario Woods shot 20 times by Bayview police in December. He was carrying a knife and refused to drop it. Most recently is the homeless man, Luis Gongora, in the Mission District. So hunger strike it is for them. So, well, I don't know, y'all. I don't know. But there's more.
Is there like a mental health angle to this?
I think there is. I think they're trying to say that the police don't even look into that before.
Yeah, they don't.
Because it's not, you know, the homeless dude probably needed a little more assistance than just being a homeless dude. Yeah. The dude that got shot not because he was mentally ill, they probably didn't know that at the time. But if you take time to figure this stuff out, you know, talk to people, you know.
What?
Like my nine to five is in the mental health field. And like the supervisors, like, don't call the cops first.
Yeah.
No, not never.
Pops off,
really?
Call the cops because they don't know what they're doing.
They're not trained for none of that shit.
Say they don't have proper training.
No.
That should be like the minimum. It's to know how to deal with all different people.
But they don't care.
They don't care.
No. They should kill you right away.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, the people in my job, everybody that we service is either Puerto Rican, Dominican, or black.
Yeah. So it's already a level of.
When the cops come in, they're like, oh, he's danger. Bugging, let's get him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it. It's not like, oh, he's developmentally disabled. Let's take it easy. Or try to, you know, talk him, redirect, prompt. Those are the kind of things that we.
Yeah.
No, I mean, like, redirecting and prompting people. I mean, come on.
Like, you do that in your regular everyday life. Yeah. Like, you're supposed to, you're a policeman, you're supposed to do that, like, as a,
social
like, you,
skills.
Like, that's your,
yeah,
you should
much.
Be graduating some shit, like, knowing, what did you say, talk, redirect?
Talk is prompting, redirecting, and just talking to them, yeah.
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 Or if there's an accident and some wild shit is happening in the street, and now you're a police officer that has to redirect traffic and direct people around a crime scene or something like that. You have to be able to do that.
Exactly. Yeah. Redirecting is real easy. We do it every day in our life. Like when someone's talking that BS and you just switch the topic.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Just make them focus on something. Make
else. Exactly.
Child.
I did that one time. No, I was in junior. No, I was in junior high school, and this dude.
It was an attention deficit thing.
No, I was in junior high school. I was in junior or intermediate school. And this cat was trying to fight me, and like he must have been really dumb, cause I got him to like stop thinking about fighting me, and walk away and go bother somebody else.
Yeah, that mantra.
Like it was so, but it was so smooth. You know what I mean? Then later on, that same cat didn't want to fight me, but I raced him. I beat him in a foot race, and like he's one of the baddest kids in school. Became like my friend. Everybody paid me mad respect because I beat this fat nigga running.
I hate you.
And
today.
I don't. And I you know. You know how I'm not into that shit. But nah, he's. It didn't. It. Of course, I was gonna beat this nigga running.
Yeah,
but because he was a bully.
Right. People.
Everybody
just,
was like, yeah.
You did take a loss.
You did that.
And I just ran to the wall. I was like, yes.
Well, one more before we turn up. I need y'all to give me some affirmations after this one because this is new. Information and another story about cops not doing what they're supposed to do.
Yeah.
A kid in Baltimore had a BB gun.
Mm,
about that.
And it was reported that he ran from cops, which people do.
Well, they always say that.
But witnesses have come forward to say that he also said it's not real. But again, what's the theme of all these stories? They don't investigate shit. And now he's dead. 14-year-old teenager in Baltimore was carrying a BB gun. He's not dead. Excuse me. He's non-fatally shot, but he's wounded. And he has a problem now. You know what I'm saying? Commissioner Kevin Davis said that two plainclothes detectives were driving down East Baltimore Street when they spotted a boy carrying what Davis identified as a replica semi-automatic pistol. First of all, these BB guns look too real, though. Yeah. Like, that's another level. I get it. It's not supposed to look that real.
Right.
But also, actual gun? It's this right here.
It's a real looking real.
Hold up, y'all.
On a side note, oh, damn.
Yeah. It does look real.
Yeah, they do.
But if you had enough time to have a conversation with the kid for the kid to say it's not real, then okay, put it down. Let me arrest you or some shit.
It's all about how people use shit, you know, what they do. Like, people be mad at technology. It's not technology, it's fucking stupid ass people. It's like, what are you doing with what you have, you know? But your shit is like malicious and.
Yo, the thing that
Yeah.
I never saw the video, but I heard it.
Son, a gun. When you get pistol whipped, that's like, I don't think people understand like what that shit is, yo. Like,
can I get hit with a hammer? Probably.
Pretty much, yeah.
No. That's because it's heavy like a hammer.
Yeah.
Shoot me in the leg, don't pistol whip me.
And in your hearts.
No, not in the knees. That shit is a wrap. Don't pistol whip me.
And in the movement, and in the prisons, and in the playgrounds.
It's August one, it's crazy too. I say with the voiceover at the end.
Stand by.
And you know I listen to these. I don't play shit without listening to it. I don't care who it is. I'm like, let me listen to it first. Nah, but I like, that's why I picked those two. Yeah.
Sweet sacred buried love songs.
Oh, they're not.
Let black be sacred. Let black be sacred street warriors and queens, uniting and loving within.
Plug it into that.
Let black be sacred in your heart.
Hilarious.
Black be.
I can hear this part.
Be black.
Hey, Gordon Parks, what's going on?
Black.
Stand by. August by Sarah White, our guest.
I like that one.
Today on TK in the AM. We just back here having conversations about conversations about conversations. And
yeah, it's just.
Tell us about this song.
So. The song is right on time with the past conversation about police brutality, just the general hunting of brown people in general by the cops. And I just got out of the jungle doing this yoga training with women of color for a month in Costa Rica. And I come out, and all I can hear about is just, like, more people getting executed. And there's so many reasons why, you know, because they look scary, because they look like their hand was going for their pocket, because they turned around too fast. And I had to find a way to get back to, like, just not even that Black Lives Matter, that's obvious, but, like, black is sacred. You know, we're coming from kings and queens. We need to be filled up with love. And I'm thinking about my seeds, my daughters, looking at this and asking me, why are they shooting this kid in the park? Why are they shooting this guy because he stole something or he was selling cigarettes on the street?
Right.
Why is this happening? And I didn't have any answers that made any sense, because it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
So I thought about, you know, my way of healing, my way of, you know, kind of putting some, I don't know, just trying to find some way to keep going and keep fighting and keep marching and keep educating, was to just fill us back up with that sacred space. And so that song for me was just, you know, reminding them that beyond what they're seeing, knowing what they really are, knowing their worth, knowing our beauty.
Yeah.
You know.
Ooh. How do you mother and be and show them like the activism besides the music? How do you like? Do you take them?
Yeah, they march.
They march with you. Yeah, like
in Minneapolis, Lamar Clark was recently executed, shot in the head by the cops, and we took over the 4th precinct. So like, not only were we out there marching, we straight up took over the precinct. Like, I'm talking like, we had fires, we had food, we had clothes, like, took over the whole area. I mean, the precinct was graphed up.
Wow.
And the cops basically locked themselves inside. And how long were we out there?
18 days.
Weeks, you know? Until they basically just, like, did some overnight, took over the precinct back. But I mean,
yeah.
Minneapolis came out and really, like, you know, we weren't going anywhere, and my kids were out there with me, you know.
Wow.
There was times where we couldn't be out there because actually, like, white supremacists came and started shooting at protesters.
Oh.
I mean, it's been real. It's really real.
Yeah.
Over there right now.
When your kid, what are, like, some of the questions that your girls ask you, like, about what's going on?
They ask me why cops want to kill us. They ask me why people call the cops. They ask me why the cops even have to be around. They're terrified. They're not afraid of the protesters. They're scared when they see, you know, boys in blue showing up. They're like, it's time to go, you know? And they ask me just kind of like, what about their skin makes them not worth living? And those are questions that are hard for me to digest.
What about their skin?
Exactly.
Little kid skin, y'all.
So that for me was so heavy that I had to make that song. I had to figure out a way to keep explaining to them that it's not their fault. It's the ignorance of other people. It's other people with broken souls, and, you know, it's deep.
It's so crazy.
It's hard.
I'm like, how, Sway? Like, I don't even. And
I don't even have an answer.
So you do yoga. Is there something that the little ones need to do to decompress? Like, how are you helping them come down from that? Because when I go march, I get turned up.
Yeah.
I feel a ways. Then I'm excited in like not a crazy way. You know what I'm saying? I'm excited with this fervor of like, fuck this shit. Mm-hmm. So I imagine inside of a small tiny body, and you have two of them that you have to like protect and watch over.
Totally.
Well, how do you do?
I try to find a balance. Like last time we went out, we marched. You know, they feel really safe because it's most of our community and friends. But afterwards, I'm like, we're getting ice cream sundaes. You know, like
you
gotta find a balance where I'm like, you're still you right now. You don't need to let this like corrupt your spirit growing, but I want you to understand that these are the times we live in, understand that this is real life.
Like, this is a
I'm
thing.
Not gonna hide this from
right.
you because this is real. But afterwards, we're about to like go watch a funny movie or like do something just to let them feel light because they deserve that. They don't
That's
need to,
good.
Like,
and I mean, I think it's an example of what people should do. Well, we always talk about that. Like, if something comes up and we're gonna go out in the street and get some, you know, cover it, be on the ground about something, we say, well, first of all, you gotta prepare yourself for what you're about to go into because you don't know. I mean, life is you don't know what's gonna happen in life in general. But when you go to a space where people have all kinds of energy and they have a lot of anger, some people are ignorant, there's good spirits there, and then there's a lot of terrible shit. So you prepare yourself for that.
Exactly.
And then you go do it. And then after that, you decompress. You have a conversation, or you go watch some funny ass shit. But you have to balance yourself out because you're just gonna be sitting around with all this in you.
Well,
you
I'm a little bit like a hippie too, so I bring like rose quartz and copal or like whatever that we can do to create a safe space around them as well. Because as a mom, I'm not really trying to put them in a situation that's gonna spiritually break them.
Yeah.
You know? But I do want them to be there with me. I don't want to separate my my role in activism from them. But they'll be protected. They got their sage. They got things with them, and they know they're in my hands the whole time.
Yeah.
And if anything feels messed up, like the cops came while we took over the highway, I heard the sirens coming, and I knew. I'm like,
it's time to go.
Bad.
Yeah,
let's roll. Let's get a look.
Right, yeah, sixth sense. Yeah.
And right when we leave, the cops start hemming up everybody.
Yeah.
Wow.
Taking all my friends to jail, and I just like, I'm like, I don't want them to see that part of it. So I just create a little safety net.
Yeah.
You know?
Right.
That's dope.
Ooh. One last thing, because I was thinking about this. Yo, so some people are like, well, you know, like, do you have to like include them? Do you have to show them? Like, why can't they just grow up with that same sensibility as every other kid? Police are for your safety, and you call them when you need help. Like, I know the answer, but I mean, you know, somebody will ask you that and they'll be like, well, why do you have to include them in all this? Like, it wasn't happening at your door, you know,
I mean, it's down the block from my door. Boop. You know, boop. Number one.
Yeah.
But number two, I don't bring them to everyone.
Yeah.
Like, I bring them out to ones that I know that have been curated in a way where they're like, here's an area where youth is safe.
Yeah.
These brothers are going to be kind of controlling the outside and watching out. I don't bring them every time. I'm out there a lot more than I want them to be. But
yeah.
I want them to understand that even though the cops are here to protect them, the system is very corrupt.
Yeah.
And I would hate for something to happen with a police than them not to understand the system.
Yeah.
Yeah. Woo, child.
You're keeping them from being ignorant. You're preparing them for life. That's what you're doing.
Ms. Chalet Lady, Mrs. Chalet Lady 7 said that's not an option for our our children. Right.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
It seems like with this has always been happening. I'm not going to say like, oh, this is an escalation. It might be an escalation, but there's an escalation of the awareness of it.
Yeah.
And now there's a whole generation of kids who are being exposed to the awareness of this violence. Mm. So to me, I'm very curious about what the next generation of kids are going to be bringing to the table. I mean, because in the 70s we had, you know, the Bronx was getting torn down, so then hip hop was made. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. So now what is the result, the artistic result?
I mean, like the yin to the yang of this is that, like, the bounce back.
Yeah.
Feeling what will be created now.
Yeah.
They're trying to tear something down, but something else will be made, I think, in the next generation.
Always.
It's almost our time here, but Sarah, yo, what else is going on in your world that we should know about? Where can people in New York see you while you're here? Touch you, breathe you.
I'm running all around everywhere.
Yeah.
Y'all gotta come find me running. But you can find me, like, I just put out this video with like 40 queens in it. It's called Siren. So if you look up Sarah White Siren, I promise it's worth your time.
Yes.
You could find my album Laughing at Ghosts.
When you say 40 queens.
Queens.
Like,
I'm saying, like, my ladies are dope.
Yeah.
Yeah.
40.
40.
Out here. Biblical 40. Numbers, y'all. Deep, 40. Okay.
Yes.
Whew.
We're just being free and unapologetic, as I said before.
I love it.
Just look up. I'm the only black Sarah White if you're looking for Sarah White up there. There's other Sarah White, but you'll find me. You'll find me.
I hit that Google and I said, no.
You're like, that's
no.
Not her.
No. Check.
Yes, exactly.
Sarah White Black on Instagram.
I'm on Instagram.
On Twitter.
On the socials. Twitter. Yes.
I'm recently trying to get up on Snapchat. I keep forgetting I have Snapchat.
Yeah. That's why I'm
Trisha
like.
You gotta remind me. I'm like, dang, I haven't snapped. I forgot about Snapchat. We busy out here.
Yeah.
Yo, Remick B. Nice said sriracha on everything.
Well, that's true.
All
bright red.
Bright red.
I can't.
BHT in there. It's like a preservative.
Yeah.
Not good for you.
Oh.
Well, just little dips.
Last year, starting to doing that on the pizza.
Yeah.
Started putting it on
hot
the pizza.
Sriracha on pizza, yo.
It's good on curry. Cabbage.
You know what? It's almost our time.
You into kimchi heavy? We gotta have a conversation. Mm. There's a spot that's got kale kimchi.
Okay, we're gonna talk about it.
You know what? Let them.
Kimchi falafel.
Colors for lunch.
We'll talk.
So we're gonna go around the room. We got about 6 minutes left till the end of the show.
Amen.
Wow. Let me ask you guys, what's your affirmations, man?
Yeah.
Conscious, would you like to show them how it's done? I always do this to you. I know.
No, because you
No, you do
think.
It today.
I gotta think.
Okay, thank
you.
Deep, I know you know about Affirmation Friday.
Yeah, I got some affirmations.
He had some good ones last time he was on with us.
I was on Monday.
Was it
Motivation Monday.
Well,
it's the same spirit, so roll with that.
He's like, let's be correct.
What's your affirmation, Deep?
I affirm that I will, this is a little shallow, but.
It's yours.
Yeah.
It's
affirmation.
I affirm that I will re-up on pre-order for the new album. But
yes.
Hell yeah, man. Prosperity.
And I affirm that I will... I affirm that I would get a new job. I love my job, but I don't like being in the office.
Yeah.
I used to be I'm a field guy.
Yeah.
I affirm that I will be in the field more.
In the field more, okay.
That's a good way. I like
that. Yes, we affirm that for you
too. As you shall receive, bro.
Colors for lunch and in the field.
Colors for lunch, all
yes.
Uh-huh.
Conscious.
All right. Yeah. Hey, Sarah White, you got any affirmations?
I want you to go first on purpose.
Oh, no, exactly. Wait. No. All right. Hey, you got one? Come here. Yo, like, really, my brain isn't.
All right, give it, y'all.
And I'm just, hot.
It's hot in here.
I'm wild hot in here.
Yeah,
gotta
be good.
OG intern. Come on, OJ Simpson.
Yeah. Don't call him that.
I know. You look nice today.
Don't sit in my lap either.
It's a full house.
All right, bro.
So,
here he go. Go for it.
So my affirmation is basically, life is a circle. Speak love, great intention, be loving to life, and life will boomerang back the same vibes to you. Affirmation Friday.
Woo!
He just did the Drake. He looked at his phone and read his affirmation.
That's all right.
That's what's up. That's
Zumba
up,
Liz
yo.
Said, OG looks nice every day. You do look nice every day. Step in your style.
Zumba, 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 Zumba.
All right. Conscious.
How much time we got left?
I just extended us 5 minutes.
All right. Shit. Mm-hmm. Let's see. And, you know, everything has been pretty good this year, last year. And I think I just affirm a continuance in kind of growth and letting my life, the things that happen that I manifest in my life, continue to confirm that it's okay, it's cool, you know, and that living unapologetically is a very important thing, you know. Do thing, health comes first, you know, and say no all the time. I love saying no. And fire clients if you have to.
Real.
I just affirm all that shit.
Yeah, real.
I
mean,
like, boss shit, just do that.
Fire your clients, yo, because that shit ain't good for your spirit. That's it.
Fire your goddamn clients.
Shit. Miss Sarah White, black. The black one.
All right. So I affirm that this year will be very prosperous for me.
Yeah.
Word.
I'm going to be financially free.
Yes.
Dope. I affirm that I'm going to allow others to love me, and I'm going to love myself really hard this year. Mm. Again, unapologetically.
Unapologetically.
I also affirm that if something isn't feeding me life, I'm going to dust it from my feet.
Whoa.
That's where I'm at.
You heard?
Yes. Yes. Yeah, shout out to Kali in the chat room. She said there's a good book about firing your clients. It's called Book Yourself Solid by Michael Port. Chat roommates be
That's
knowing.
What I'm talking about.
They be knowing. Okay, Book Yourself Solid, y'all.
Let me read that.
Reading list, and they into Dust It From My Feet.
That's beautiful.
I got that from church. I just started. I don't go to church very often.
Say
that. I went to church, and he was like, I was like, man, he's just talking straight.
You were supposed to get that.
Nobody else. And he's like, if they ain't loving you or giving you life, why are you sitting in the murk? And he said, dust it from your feet and leave. And I was just like, I couldn't even get up. I was like, oh my God, this is so dirty.
Yeah, that's great.
What kind of church is this?
I don't even know, girl.
Turned up. You just went.
I don't even know what kind of church is. I don't normally go. But
she just got the word.
Been like, it's a practice. Yoga. I go to church. Like, I'm trying to like find things to keep myself woke.
Find it like.
Yeah.
Because it's really easy
keep
for
your
me
vibe
to like go back to sleep even though I'm really woke.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to keep myself
keep the vibe.
Why she out here speaking? It's easy for me to go back to sleep even though I'm really woke.
Yeah.
Reminds me of yoga. Anger is easy.
Yo, y'all are hilarious. We got
You know what's funny now, you know, just to say with the church thing, if you need quiet and you need to think and you want to do a meditation, there's always these big ass churches in New York
that are open,
son. Just go right in there. And there's certain churches, if you want to know, I can tell you to go to where you just feel a good spirit in the space. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm big for that. Like when you walk in the room, like I've just like left places because I'm like, no, I don't feel good.
Yeah.
But there are certain churches that I don't know, man. I don't know what they're sitting on. I don't know what they did in that building specifically.
Time to go.
But the building is perfect. It's perfect for clarity. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I used to do that when I lived here. I would just like have a double at work or whatever and just like go into a church and just kick
sit
it
down
for like 5 minutes. Just like clear my head.
Right.
Ooh, Lord. Inspired here today, y'all. It's almost our time. Got
now
about 5 minutes left.
Church, but I go sit in the church.
I mean, we got a full house today, and I would be remiss if y'all just didn't just pop in on one of these, because I feel it's an epic.
She's like, no, she just shook her head. No, no.
She's like, y'all, is y'all just out here doing it? Y'all doing it. Dondi, the ghost in the machine, would you like to affirm? She got a top hat on too, family.
Yeah.
Yep.
Straight magic,
and
rabbits, all that.
So, like, yeah, you gotta.
I need to borrow top hat flow, actually.
Okay.
Yeah, you jump into that one.
All right.
Let's take it off.
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't have to be tender with it.
Yeah. Just
not to touch it.
Affirmation.
Yes.
Well, first and foremost, shout out to Keisha. It's her birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah. So with that said, let's aim for a fruitful year.
Yes.
Yes. And asking for all the abundance that we attain for.
Yeah.
And receiving it.
Yes.
Knowing it's coming at divine time.
Ooh. Mm. Divine time, y'all.
That's real.
Which watch are you wearing?
Listen, because, you know, patience is the key. It's coming. But
divine time.
Not on your time.
Yes. It's they don't even, that's not even a brand.
Okay.
It's so, just, yeah, it just is. That. Yes. Shout out to Dondi out here.
What watch are you wearing?
What watch are you wearing?
What watch are you wearing?
So, I guess I'll close out and just say, yeah, it's time. I'm going into this year. I jumped into this year, 2016, like a motherfucker. And I'm going to keep jumping into this motherfucker like a motherfucker, okay? And I affirm that for me and my friends and my family, especially because I realized that soon as I got open to this motherfucker, shit started happening for me.
For real.
And it's not going to stop happening for me. It's just going to get better. So, you know what? I think that's my affirmation, y'all. I appreciate everybody that's tuned in and turned Word. Up. So many people's tuning in for you, Sarah White. Thank you for Word being up. Here.
Yeah, thanks for having me, y'all.
Thank you for gifting me Feisty Mrs. Peabody.
I'm glad Wonderful. She's still alive. Wonderful.
A friend for Wonderful. Life. Yo, she ain't child. I think she's not going nowhere.
She's never leaving.
No. No, just so you know. Like, on some spiritual shit, too. She's just not going nowhere.
Yeah, no.
So I got a friend for life and a friend for life, y'all.
That's
Yo, shout out to Londa 3121. I just saw Londa. You jump in the chat room. We appreciate you, Boo Tasha. Appreciate you. Everybody tuned in and turned up with us. Yo, it's our time. Let's clap it up for the room. It's a very live and energetic space. Conscious.
We do that here. TK and the AM giving you three reasons to wake up Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. From 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Eastern. Only here on Bonfire Radio.
Yes.
Yo, tonight, both sides of the surface.
Macedonia to 10.
Eastern. That's going to be good.
Yes. And right now,
it's TK's birthday, and he's probably going to play some wild shit.
He's going to play some wild shit and some Prince and his birthday.
Oh, yes.
And Prince. Next up, just in case y'all missed it, episode 100 of Brunch and Budget will play right after us right now on Bonfire Radio. So get into that. Get your money right. We love you for listening.
You guys. Underwater squat.
Skirt. Y'all have a great day. We love you for listening.
Yeah.
Peace.